infrastructure. Excellency has alluded into the smart city depending and being dependent on a modern and ultra-modern infrastructure. So we are auditing that too. This, in this very same hall, a year ago, I said, we need $1 billion to deal with our infrastructure in Amman. And some people laughed at me. Some government officials called me and told me, what are you talking about? If Amman needs $1 billion, what would the country need? Yesterday, I had to go and pay condolences to General Shobak, His Excellency, for having lost his father in Shobak. So I drove into Shobak and back, 2 hours in, 2 hours out. You know, I thought that the entire government of Jordan should drop everything and concentrate on one thing, a road from here to Aqaba, because it is the artery. It is the heart. And I looked at this road that has been beaten and time and again. And where are we? If we don't, and it's the only thing that we have. When the late King Hussein in 1973 decided to have a highway to Aqaba, he was way far sighted than anyone else. So for 2025, for a man to have the proper infrastructure to cope with to have the carrying capacity, which my great friend Mr. Awame, who is the head of the Jumu'iyyat al-Muslimin to Iskan, he and I are in great battle here. He wants to build more, I will tell him build less and spread out. The city has a carrying capacity. The infrastructure needs to be looked into. So in 2025, what do I have? So it is not spontaneous, it is the intention. Again, I'm using your words, Dr. Klaus. The third is legislative. We have to audit the city from the regulations. What regulations do we have? We're talking about 1968 construction in Nizam al-Abdi, 68, 75, 90 amendments and all. We need a modern one. We have to modernize, we have to go into the green construction, and we have to go into the renewable energy and all sorts of things. So we need to have the proper legislative infrastructure also for moving forward. So all of this comes around urbanization. I'm looking at Amman in 2025 for something around 8 to 10 million people. If there is no city, a new Amman, southeast of here, in the Madonna area, or on the belt that Her Excellency is moving forward as Minister of Transport, and His Excellency Minister of Public Works is extremely involved in preparing the grounds. If we don't have another city, and I suggested to the highest authority in the country, I said, why don't we go to Qatrani, in that flat area, and build a city for a 250,000 and build a railroad or a light train which takes 25 minutes to 30 minutes to get into the city of Amman. This is to, again, the intention, and His Excellency, Dr. Klaus said, look for capital for larger cities, not the capital. Go out and look for cities. This way I can enhance Karak and make Karak governorate as an attraction. Move to Ma'an and build the dry dock or the dry port in Ma'an, and that will also draw in another 100,000-200,000 a year, which will make it another city of Bali. Urbanization is not imagination, it's not a fiction, it's a reality, it is the intention. So I'm so glad that our keynote speaker, and a man who of a vision, a man who has done cities like Barcelona, speaks out of experience. It has to be determined where are we going, then all of the smart things we talk about will be only enablers and tools.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I may mention in support that the president of Egypt decided to build the new Cairo, complete Cairo city as another Cairo capital. So that proves the supports the point. We need to be fast in our presentation so that we have a chance to hear everybody. I would like to ask the Minister of Housing,
yes,
and then the Minister of Transport, and then Your Excellency. So you, after hearing the Jordanian perspective, then we can hear the international.
Thank you.
Your Excellency, Dr. John Klaus, Your Excellency, our dear host, Dr. Tal Wazale, it is a great pleasure to have Your Excellency, Dr. John Klaus, with us today here in Amman, the capital of Jordan, this country that has been urbanizing rapidly during the last several decades. Your Excellency, as all international reports indicate, urbanization along with the growth of population have been exerting big burdens on the country's overall development, land, and residential. The influx of the Syrian refugees had several changes on the social and demographic status. The housing trends have changed. Some new urbanization went out of the planned zone areas. Rents went up, demand on housing became severe, whereas the market was not able to fulfill the needs of both Jordanians and Syrian refugees in the host communities.